In this video, we're going to take a look at widgets on the iPad. I like to think of a widget as a small version of an app that lives on your home screen or your lock screen. It shows you quick information such as the weather forecast or your calendar, your events from your calendar, or your reminders from the Reminders app without opening up the full app. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at these widgets on the iPad. Let's go over to my iPad. First thing we're going to look at is how we can install widgets. We basically have two different ways to do that. We can do this directly from an app icon, or we can do it by editing the home screen. I'm going to call that the old school way of doing it. So let's first look at how we can do this from an app icon. So I have my reminders here. What I would like to do is have it show what's in my inbox. How can I do that? Well, we just turn this into a widget, and then we tell it to show my reminders from my inbox. That's one of my lists called the inbox. So what we need to do is long press on it, and when I long press on it, we get a contextual menu, and then you're going to see up at the top there, we have some icons there. Basically, when we're on the icon at the far left, that is the app icon. That's just a standard app icon. But when we go over to the right, when we tap on those, what it's going to do is it's going to turn that app icon into a widget. And depending on which one we tap on, it's going to be a different size. So let's just go with the first one. So I just tap on it. And now we can see that we have a widget here. And I can actually see my to-dos. Now, this isn't that large. I'd like to make this a little bit larger. We have a couple different ways to do that. I can long press on it, and as you can imagine, what I'm able to do is go and make it larger. So let's go ahead and go to the largest. And now we can see it is quite large. Or what I can do is I can go into the jiggly mode, and when I long press on it and wait till the apps jiggle, what you're going to see in the lower right-hand corner is a resize handle. I drag that around to resize that widget. So we can use the contextual menu, or we can go into the jiggly mode, and then we can drag it to resize it. In a lot of cases, I just find it easier to just long press on it and then choose my size from here. Now, I mentioned that I wanted to show my to-dos from my inbox. How do I know that these are from my inbox? How do I tell it to go to my inbox? Well, basically what we have to do is we have to edit that widget. So to edit it, we long press on it, we get the contextual menu, and then you're going to see edit widget. I tap on that, and now I can go and edit that widget. So we can see that it is grabbing my reminders from the inbox. But if I wanted to change that, I tap on that and I can select which one I want. So let's just go with today. So now what it's going to do is it's going to show me all of my reminders that are due today. So that's how we can edit a widget. Now, what about moving them? Well, we move them around just like an app icon. So I just long press on it and I drag it and I can move this around where I want. So if I wanted it on the right side, now it's on the right side. And then if you want to remove it, we have a couple different options. I long press on it, and then I can tap on remove widget. What it's going to do is it's going to remove the widget and the icon. But if you just want to turn it back into an app icon, you can do that by tapping on this little icon here. So I want to keep the reminders icon, the app icon, but I just don't want that widget anymore. So now what I do is I just tap on the little one there, and we can see we have my reminders back as an app icon. So that's one way of installing widgets. We just long press on the app icon, and then we can turn that app icon into a widget, or turn that app into a widget. Now, not all apps support this. This is up to the developer if they want to add widgets. So if you don't see the option to turn an app icon into a widget, that means that developer doesn't support or didn't build in widgets into that app. So that's one way. Just long press on it, and then we can select what widget we want. There's another way of doing it, and that's what I'm going to call old school way of doing it. We can see all of our widgets that are available in a list and then add them from there. To do that, what we need to do is we need to go into the jiggly mode. We have to edit our home screen. So I'm going to long press on any one of my app icons here, and I long press on it until they start jiggling. This is what I call the jiggly mode. And when we're in the jiggly mode, you're going to see we have edit in the upper left-hand corner. When I tap on that, we have the option to add a widget. So now what I do is I just select that, and we're going to get a list of all of the apps that support widgets. So let's go with the reminders. I just swipe up until I find reminders, and you're going to see we have my three sizes here. So I just swipe, find the one that I want. I can tap on add widget, and what it'll do is it'll add it to the upper left-hand corner. Or what I like to do is I just like to drag this out and place it where I want. So now I'm going to drag this out, I place it where I want, and there's that widget in there. And now I can go and add more widgets. Once I add that widget, it is just a standard widget. So you're going to see that when I long press on it, I can edit this, and then I can even turn it into an app icon. And then if I want to remove it, I can also just remove it. So when we add it from the list, it basically does the same thing as long pressing on a widget. But when we do add it from a list, let's go back into that list. The nice thing about going into a list, long press on it until they jiggle. When we add a widget from this list here, we actually can see all the different sizes for a widget. As an example, let's go over here to calendar. You're going to see that I have a number of different widgets here that are available. And when I look at these, you're going to see at the top, it tells me what that one is. So this one's up next. This is going to be my next event or meeting. And then when I swipe to the left, this one is going to be events. So it's plural. This is going to keep track of my upcoming events in a different way. I can see what it is today and then also tomorrow. And then I can also see 3 days here. So I can choose from any one of these widgets and I can keep going. Maybe I just want to see a monthly calendar on my home screen. Or what I'd like to do is see this in a list. So we have a lot of different options here for some of these widgets. And all I have to do is just drag it. So I just take this and I drag it and I place it where I want. When we go to clock, you're going to see that I have a number of different clock icons or clock widgets. So I just swipe and choose the one that I like. So we have more options when we go to this old school way of the list. And the nice thing about this is I can see all of the widgets that are available to me. When you are done, all you do is just tap outside of there and then you tap anywhere where there's not an app icon and you've installed that widget. So those are the two different ways to install widgets. The last thing I want to show you is how we can stack widgets. So let's say I wanted to take this widget and stack it on top of that widget, and then I can easily switch between them. How can I do that? Well, basically all you do is just drag one on top of the other. So I'm going to long press on my calendar widget. I drag it on top of the other one. You're going to see that the border turns black. So when I let go, what it's going to do is it's going to turn this into a stack. So now I have two widgets. You're going to see right down here there are a couple of dots. So that's telling me that there are two widgets there. And to switch between them, all I have to do is just swipe up and down on that widget. So I'm looking at my calendar widget, I swipe, and now I'm looking at my reminders. Swipe again, I'm back at my calendar. We can add more widgets. In fact, what I'm able to do is add another reminders widget. So when we're looking at my reminders here, this is showing my inbox. What I would like to do is I would like to have it show what is due today, as well as my inbox. So I need to add another reminders widget. Again, we can add more than one widget up from the same app. So what I need to do is I just need to go to that list. This is the easiest way of doing it. I go to edit, add widget. We go over here to reminders. I find the same size widget. They do have to be the same size. So there's that widget. I drag it on top of the other one there. So we can see that it's, whoops, try it again here. Come on, you can do it. It's a little tricky. There we go. Let go. Now that is on there as well. But what it's doing is it's still showing me the inbox. So we can see that it's the same thing. Well, now all I need to do is just edit one of these. So I'm going to long press on it. And then we go over here to edit reminder. And I'm going to say this one is today. So now this is showing me what is due today. And when I swipe, this is showing my inbox. And then I swipe again. Remember, there's three of them here. I get my calendar. So we're able to stack these widgets and even add more than one instance from a particular app. With stacks, we can also change the order. So if I wanted to change how this flips around here, what I'm able to do is long press on it, and then you're going to see Edit Stack. When I tap on Edit Stack, what I can do is view all of the widgets in that stack, and I can remove them, or what I can do is I can reorder them. So I just drag this and place it where I want. So now I just change the order of that. So we can remove it or change the order. And then when we're done, we tap on Done, and those changes have been saved. So if you have a large stack, what you're able to do is set the order of how those different apps are in that stack. So that's how we work with widgets on the iPad. As you can see, they're basically an extension of an app, and it gives us quick information about that app. It could be my reminders, my events, it could be files from the Files app, it could be a 10-day forecast from the Weather app. We have two different ways to do this, to add these widgets. We can long press on the app icon and then turn that app icon into a widget. Or what we can do is we can go into the Jiggly mode, editing our home screen, and then when we tap on Edit and then Add Widgets, what we're able to do is see a list of all of the widgets and then drag them onto our home screen from there. You do have a few more options when you do it that way. And then, of course, we can create stacks of widgets. So that's how we work with widgets on the iPad. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, I have a couple of different options if you want to help support my efforts in creating these videos. The first one is I have danstutorials.com. This is where I place all of my videos. I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius. This is a membership-based site, and when you become a member, I'll take out all of the ads from the videos. You have access to that AI assistant. Another option is through my courses. If you don't like subscriptions and you want to have a course on a specific device, such as the iPhone or the iPad, you can go to Dan's Online Courses. Now, as of this recording, I only have a course on the iPhone, but I plan on adding this video and more for a course on the iPad and then eventually for the Mac as well. And those are not a subscription. It's a one-time purchase and then you have access to all of those videos, not a subscription. Either way, what you're doing is you're helping support my efforts in creating these videos. I am not part of some large organization. I'm just a small business working out of a corner office of my house. So when you become a member or purchase a course, you are directly helping me create these videos or supporting my effort in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com or Dan's Online Courses for more information. And thanks for watching.